Hello and welcome to the fifth installment of the Tawa Podcast. I'm your host, Tawa, and today I'm going to be talking about a thing that I have been thinking of a lot. Plans for the future. Last night, right? I spent like an hour just pondering and planning out this episode. I kind of forgot like what I talked about, but I'll try to remember it. Initially this was going to be like at just a normal video. But I spent like hours thinking last night, and I don't think that I could like get all of those thoughts that I had in an hour, like multiple hours, and cram them all into like a 7-minute long video. Or however long my normal videos are. So I decided that I am just going to record myself speaking about it on my podcast so you guys can listen to me speak about my plans for the future while you do something. You can do anything. Do something. Anyways, where was I? Oh yeah, that's right, plans for the future. Something that I would really like to do in the future, like, say, when I buy a house or something, right, I'd like to have a lot of paintings on the walls, because in my house, we don't have any paintings on the walls. My parents took them down years ago when I was only, like, a little kid, and so I don't remember having any paintings on walls. And I like doing paintings. I like making paintings and having art on the walls. Or it could be, like, photos, whatever, like, really cute framed things. Recently I've been getting, like, heavily into, like, watercolor and all of that, and, like, painting and stuff. Yesterday I talked about this on my previous video, but, like, I did some watercolor art of, pizza, my favorite pizza from my favorite pizza place. I photocopied that today. I made like a bajillion photocopies of it, and I'm going back there next Saturday, and I'm going to like just give a photocopy of my watercolor art to the pizza place, because they blessed me with delicious pizza. I blessed them with my amazing watercolor art. But the problem is that, like, I, like, with the printer and stuff, since I had to photocopy it, sometimes it turns green, and I don't want that to happen, but I also don't want to give away my original copy, because that holds sentimental value. Also, the photocopied ones, they look kind of washed out, and I don't know why that is, so I think I might have to redo that. But I'll do that tomorrow, whatever. Paintings. But yeah, I think that it would be, like, super cute, you know? But let's say, hypothetically, my partner may not want to have the walls adorned in my beautiful paintings and pictures, or, like, awards or whatever, if I do get any awards in the future, which I'm not sure I will be getting. Then I'll just keep them in my room. So it'll work out perfectly. Another thing that I'd like, a cute kitchen. Like, just a really, really cute kitchen. You know, because, like, I love baking and cooking and just all of that nice, amazing stuff. You know, I've always imagined just having a really cute kitchen where I can make delicious food for my family if I do ever have a family in the future. You know, even if the food tastes like poop, at least it'll be made with love. That's the ingredient I put in all of my meals. You know, I've always imagined making really nice, like, nice home-cooked dinners. Like, say, it's like a chilly winter night, or like a chilly fall evening, and I make some delicious seasonal pumpkin soup, to go along with the weather, and it's gonna be amazing. Or like a really nice casserole or cottage pie. It'll be amazing. Or like in the morning, I could make like waffles or something, and have them all on, like, really cute plates. I really want to have cute, like, cookware and utensils and silverware and plates and that kind of stuff. Because, like, I mean, like, it would be cool to have, like basic plates or whatever. Because, like, I know that basic plates are more practical or whatever because, like, the designs and stuff, like, won't wash off or anything because, like, there won't be any designs on them. But, like, and like, you know how, like, some people have, like, really fancy plates and stuff? Like, oh, honey, get out the fancy place. The guests are coming over. You know, that kind of stuff. Like, I can't have, like, separate ones. I can't just have, like, basic plates and then, like, the special plates. Because, like, I want all of the meals to be special, you know? So I would only use the special plates. And also, like, they look cooler. Because, like, I mean, do I really want to have, like, boring utensils and stuff? No. But I don't think that I can decide on utensils. Because, like, I've been thinking about this, right? Like, what kind of utensils I'd like to have in the future. Like, do I want to have those, like, really fancy, like, antique-looking ones? Because, like, those ones, they're really nostalgic. They remind me of, like, my grandparents' house. Because, like, they have those kinds of, like, fancy, you know, decorative utensil. Or not decorative, but, like, just nice-looking ones. That have, like, all of the fancy little designs on them. Or do I want to get, like, nice, sleek, modern utensils? You know? Like, even if, like, they're not, like, even if they don't have, like, fancy designs on them or whatever, and, like, they're just, like, plain utensils, but, like, fancy, like, nice-looking utensils, you know? I've always admired having, like, tall, like, long utensils, like, knives and forks and spoons or whatever, and a nice an assortment of them, you know, not just basic knife, fork, spoon, but also, like, you know, like, little teaspoons, dessert forks, soup spoons, you know, that kind of stuff. And if they had, like, a darker kind of, like, silver or, like, dark kind of metal to them, like, that would be cool, right? Because, like, those ones, like, they look cool, they look sleek, right? But, like, I what if they clash with the plates? Because, like, if I want to have decorative plates, right, and it would be much more appropriate to have, like, decorative little antique-looking spoons and cutlery as opposed to having, you know, the fancy, flowery-looking plates with, like, tall, dark, sleek utensils. Because, like, it would clash. It wouldn't make sense. But then would I have to get, like, not fancy plates and instead just get like matching plates, because like I like it to be matching, right? Or I should just get like Galaxy Pete's Cat, like everything, like, you know how you can get like custom plates or whatever. What if in the future, instead of getting like normal plates or like cute flowery plates, I just get like Galaxy Pizza Cat ones, because I love me some Galaxy Pizza Cat stuff, right? And that would be cool. I'd also want to have a really cute apron. Going back to the cooking thing, I'd like to just imagine just waking up early in the morning and putting on just the cutest apron ever to make delicious waffles for your family. Like, that sounds like heaven to me. So I'm looking forward to, like, hypothetically, if this does ever happen, right? But then again, this kind of conflicts, because, like, say if I do ever get, like, a partner or whatever, like, what if they don't like it? Because, like, it would be selfish of me to just, like, get all of this stuff that I, because that also makes me feel unhappy. Because, like, another thing about me, like, I'm only going to be happy if, like, the people around me are also happy. Because, like, as much as I do love having things, like, my way, and, because, like, that is, like, happy for me. But, like, I'm also going to be sad if the people around me, like my loved ones disagree with that, you know? Because, like, I want them to be happy too. And I do try to, like, how do I explain this? Like, say, if my mom and I go shopping or whatever, Like, and I, although, like, most of the time, my mom, she's gonna say stuff like, oh, yes, this is a trip for you, Tawa. Where do you want to go? What do you want to do? And she'll try to spend her money. But I'm just like, no, it's okay, mom, it's okay, mom. And I try to include her as much as I can, you know? Like, hey, mom, do you want to go to this store? Do you want to, what stores do you want to go to? I can pay for some stuff. But my mom, she's, like, super kind. But I do try to pay, like... Like, I'm gonna feel really sad and really inconsiderate and neglectful if I don't include the other people in my life. You know what I mean? And that's... It's a good thing as well. Because other people can help me decide on things. Going back to the utensils and stuff, if I do get a partner in the future, then they can help me decide on what utensils to get, and what kind of plates and that kind of stuff. I think that will be very, very, very cool. But, like, going back onto things that I cannot decide on, like, and, like, things in my future, like, cars. What kind of, like, I've been thinking about this for the past few months, but, like, what kind of car do I want to drive? Like, I'm stuck between, you know how, because, like, I always drive around, and you know how you always see, like, those, like, old people cars, and, like, they're really, like, round and cute and colorful, and those really cute circular headlights, and, like, they look like bugs, and they're so cute looking, and, like, because, like, you see, I really want to get one of those cars, right, because they're totally cute, but, like, I'd also want to get, like, a 1959, like, Ford Thunderbird, you know, Elvira's car, her, what's it called, Macabre Mobile, wait, Macabre, is it Macabre or Macabre? How do you pronounce that word? Anyways, because, like, that car, like, Elvira's car, I love Elvira, she is so cool, and she drives a super duper cool car. But I think that the, old person bug looking car, those cars will probably be much more cheaper. So I'll probably end up getting one of those things, but if I could, I would like to get a 1959 Ford Thunderbird. Going back to the bit where I get sidetracked and, tell you guys about my day today, because I forgot everything else that I was supposed to say in this episode, today I had a really good day. I went to the gym. Actually, no, I woke up, I had a protein drink for breakfast, I waited, I made pumpkin soup for dinner tonight, and it was delicious, and then my mom and I went to the gym for this fitness thingy. We got our, like, the people at the gym that I go to, they gave us, like, my mom and I, these personalized workout thingies, and so one of the nice instructor dudes, like, showed us through that. We're going back there tomorrow on Sunday to actually do the workout, which I'm looking forward to. And then my mom and I, we went home, had showers, and then we went shopping. Well, actually, we got sushi first. That was delicious. I enjoyed that. And then we went, we went to do our groceries. And guess what? I posted about this on my community page, but public service announcement. The original zero sugar Monster Energy is now available at most grocery stores in New Zealand. Like, oh my god, I've been waiting for this for so long. It's literally my most favorite Monster. So of course I had to get multiple cans of that. And then afterwards, we were gonna go thrifting, right? But the thrift store had closed, and that made me angry. But whatever, we're going back there next week. And then we went home, and then I did some roller skating, and then I ate the pumpkin soup, and it was delicious, and now I am here. And I'm recording this. Oh yeah, and guys, by the way, so many cool stuff is happening in the music world right now. But, like, it's kind of sad for me, because, like, there are so many concerts, because, like, so many of the bands I like, right, they were all on tour with each other, basically, and, like, they're going everywhere but New Zealand. Like, come on. Like, I mean, Dead Meat Nightlife is playing some shows with Bury Me With You and The Millionaires. Like, oh my god. And, like, Vampires Everywhere is, like, playing with Alisana. And also Blackville Brides are literally, like, releasing new music. Like, I'm not sure when the full Bleeders EP is coming out, but it's supposed to come out, like, sometime, wait, was it this month or next month? I forgot. And they're also on tour with Falling in Reverse, and Falling in Reverse, they're releasing new music as well. Well, Ronnie, he's releasing new music. He released that new single, and I'm pretty sure, like, an album is coming out soon, sometime in, wait, was it June or July? I don't know. One of the months that starts with J, not January, June or July. And they're on tour together on the Popular Monster Tour with Dance Gavin Dance. And also Marilyn Manson is releasing new music. Like, oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. This is so cool. And also, it wasn't, like, Motionless and White, like, didn't, like, they release some new tour dates or whatever? Like, it's so cool, right? But none of it's happening in New Zealand. It is so sad. I am so sad. Actually, no, it's not all sad. Because I'm sure that my mother's wallet will be very happy that it does not have to spend any more money. Like, my mom's wallet is not going to empty itself out on concerts. So that's nice, in a way. Sad for me, good for the wallet. Also, I think that I mentioned this in my previous video, but it's like the start of winter today. It's the 1st of June. That kind of sucks, because I've been freezing cold lately, and it's just gonna get colder. And I am not prepared for that, especially because, like, I live in New Zealand. There's literally a polar blast going on right now. A polar blast, it sounds too, I made a video about the polar blast. I'm not looking forward to it at all. When I go thrifting next week, I'm gonna try and see if I can find, like, a coat, like, a really cute looking coat to keep me warm. One, like, you know, like, those ones with the fur hoods. Need one of those. That'll keep me warm. I'm looking forward to tomorrow as well. Because, like, what's it called? My parents and I, we're going to go to town somewhere. I don't know. They haven't told me. They just said that we're going to do something tomorrow. And then I asked my mom about it, and she was just like, oh, I don't really know. Just something. I think we're going to go to the cinemas. We've been meaning to go to the cinemas for months now. I wanted to see the new Garfield movie, but my mom said that that's for babies, and that I'm not 5, I'm 13. So instead we're going to see Planet of the Apes, I think. I don't know, that is if we even go to the cinemas. And then she was saying something about getting kebabs later on. But then my dad also said that we could, like, go, like, far away, like, into, like, the faraway town. Like, not the town that's nearby my town, but, like, the one that's far away with all of the fancy shops and stuff. And we could go there and get some stuff there. But, like, it's confusing, but I'm looking forward to it. Also, my mom and I need to go to the gym to do the workout thing again in the morning. And so now I need to end this podcast so that I can choose my clothes for tomorrow. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Make sure to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you get all the latest updates. Bye-byes.